Hello everybody, today we'll discuss about dosage compensation of genes. The term dosage compensation was first coined by the scientist Muller. It was first observed in Drosophila, later it was also seen in case of humans also. So what do you mean by dosage compensation? As the term says, something to be balanced. The genes, the amount of the product produced by the genes should be compensated with the other. So it is called as dosage compensation of genes. So dosage compensation of genes is actually done by the inactivation of the one of the X chromosomes in the females. Females are called as homogametic. We also studied in the sex determination of the Drosophila as well as in human. The females are called as homogametic sex because they have two X chromosomes, whereas male are called as heterogametic cells because they have one X chromosome and one Y chromosome. So here in case of female, since they have two X chromosomes, one of the X chromosome will get inactivated. Why this inactivation has to be done between the male and the female? Because as I just mentioned, the amount of protein produced by two X chromosome will be more when compared to that of the one X chromosome produced by the males. So in order to balance the compensation or the amount of protein coded by the genes on the X chromosome will be double in case of female when compared to that of the male. In order to balance this, they will, one of the X chromosome in case of female will get inactivated during the lifetime of the development. So that inactivated chromosomes are called as sex chromatin, or it's also called as bar bodies. Bar bodies are nothing but they are the inactivated X chromosome as seen in the nucleus in the condensed structure. Such inactivated chromatin material are temporary. As I just mentioned, it is not permanent. It will be only temporary in the certain part of the life cycle. So it's also called as facultative chromatin. But it resumes its activity once entering the germline. Okay. Now, the inactivation of the X chromosome is a random phenomenon. I have just mentioned that it is not a permanent, this is only temporary period of time. So it resumes back its activity after a certain period of time. So since we have two X chromosomes, I mean to say the females have two X chromosomes, so one of the X chromosome will get inactivated. So we don't know which of the X chromosome will get inactivated, whether it's a paternal X chromosome or the maternal X chromosome. So as I just mentioned, it is a random phenomenon. Maybe the paternal X chromosome may get inactivated or the maternal X chromosome may also get inactivated. Okay, so as I just mentioned, such inactivated X chromosomes are also called as bar bodies. So these bar bodies are nothing but they are the inactivated X chromosome which is observed in the nucleolus of a cell. Okay, so the term the bar bodies, this bar body term was first given by Barr and Bertram in the year 1949. So these inactivated X chromosome, actually they are the one which is going to take the stains too much. So since they are deeply stained because they are heterochromatized completely, so they take up the stain too much. So shows deeply stained chromatin body in the female cell. So in case of male, it will not take any stain because they have only one X chromosome and one Y chromosome. There is no another X chromosome to get inactivated. So in case of female, they are called as sex chromatin positive, and in case of male, they are called as sex chromatin negative because there is no bar bodies in case of males. Only you can see the bar bodies in case of females. Now, when this bar bodies is going to appear, this bar bodies generally appears in the interphase stage of a cell. Interphase stage means you know that it is only in the resting stage you are able to see the sex chromatin appear. Okay, generally sex chromatin are heavily stained and have a specific position in each of the tissues. So as per the literature survey, it has been observed that the position of the sex chromatin is going to vary in the tissues and also in the species. Sometimes it may be attached attached to the nucleolus of the cell. So if you assume this is a cell and this is a nucleus, and here you can make it out there is a nucleolus, you can make it out very closely the sex chromatin may be attached. Okay, you can see that very closely attached to the nucleolus, or it might be attached to the nuclear membrane also. Sometimes it might get attached to the nuclear membrane also, or it may be free in the nucleoplasm. Somewhere in the nucleoplasm it may be seen freely. Okay, or sometimes it may also appear in the form of a rod-like structure. attached to the nuclear membrane. So if it is appearing like a lateral structure in the nucleus, then it is called as drumstick. So this drumstick care appearance are seen in the neutrophil cells. As I told you, only in the female cell you are going to observe the drumstick like appearance or the bar bodies. So here in the neutrophil cell you are able to observe this rod like structure. So they are called as drumsticks. Okay, so they are given with the different names. They are called as bar bodies, or sometimes it is called as sex chromatin, or it may be called as drumstick or facultative sex chromatin. Now we'll go for the Lyon hypothesis. What is this Lyon hypothesis means? It is something related to the sex chromatin only. And this Lyon hypothesis was first demonstrated by M.F. Lyon. So as per this hypothesis, based on the number of X chromosome, we can predict what is the number of bar bodies the organism is going to produce. Because if a female is having two X chromosomes, these are called as normal female. If there are three X chromosomes, they are called as super females. If they are having four X chromosomes, they are called meta females. So the number of bar bodies depends upon the number of X chromosome minus one. Okay, so you can use the formula NX minus one. This is NX minus 1, where N represents the number of X chromosomes. Suppose if a female is having 2 X chromosomes, healthy normal female will have normal autosome plus 2 X chromosome. Then here the number of bar bodies is, as I have mentioned, is 2 NX minus 1. So here number of X chromosome is 2X, 2X minus 1. So the number of bar bodies is only one bar bodies can appear. If there are 3X chromosome or 3X plus 1, so number of X chromosomes here it is only 3. So 3X minus 1. You have to just mention the number of bar bodies is 1 less than the number of X chromosomes. So number of X chromosomes here it is, in this case it is 3X minus 1. So number of bar bodies is 3 minus 1 is 2. So 2. Two bar bodies are seen. In case of 4X chromosomes, 4X minus 1. So 3. The 4X minus 1 is 3. So 3 bar bodies is going to appear. Now, what might be the reason for the inactivation of the X chromosomes? So there are various reasons to explain for the inactivation of the X chromosomes. So X inactivation in mammals is not known clearly but involves certain steps. So as per the literature, it has been observed that there are few reasons to explain for the X chromosome inactivation. So the first reason is XIC. This is a center which is seen in the X chromosome. So XIC is a DNA sequence that actually regulates the formation of heterochromatin and spreads along the entire chromosome. So if this particular gene is present in the X chromosome, then it actually regulates the formation of heterochromatin, or inactivation of the X chromosome may be happening. So this X chromosome, XIC, gene is encoded with one more important molecule called as RNA molecule called as XIST RNA, which actually causes the silencing of the X chromosome inactivation. This is one reason. So now it's very clear, the inactivation of the X chromosome may happen due to the important center or inactivating center in the X chromosome called as XIC, which is a DNA sequences, along with the RNA molecule is also a reason for the silencing of the X chromosomes. So another reason is that histone 2A is be replaced by the macro H2A1. So there is one more reason also predicted by the in the literature survey. So as per this, H2A is be replaced by the another important histone called as macro H2A1. The other reason is histone deacetylization is also a reason for the inactivation of the chromosome. That is removal of the acetyl group from the histones. Okay, may also be the reason for the silencing of the genes. The other one is, the last one is hypermethylation. Generally, we have studied about the methylation of the DNA sequences. Hypermethylation. Hypermethylation means methylation will increase. May also be reason for the certain DNA sequences to undergo silencing. So these are the different reasons for the inactivation of the X chromosomes.